Hello and welcome to the news on Magic Bricks Now. I'm Amita Balachandra. Let's take a look at the top headlines at this hour. Maharashtra government goes all out to empower the home buyer. Home Ministry proposes incorporating buyer-friendly law, MOFA, into draft rules of the regulator. Could also issue fresh guidelines to police in dealing with errant builders. And the battle for Delhi continues. Now, AAP Supremo Arvind Kejriwal calls Lieutenant Governor Najib Jung a puppet of the Modi government. Dilapidated buildings are being torn down in Bhiwandi after two incidents of building collapse left 16 people dead in the last 3 weeks. As the Bhiwandi Nizampur Municipal Corporation gets cracking, evacuated residents ask, where do we go from here? And Cabinet puts the spotlight on road safety as it approves Motor Vehicle Amendment Bill 2016. Includes 68 sections from the existing Motor Vehicles Act. We tell you the impact of these amendments on your commute. Straight up to our big story here, it is Advantage Home Buyer in Maharashtra. The Home Ministry has recommended in a letter that the upcoming regulator incorporate all provisions of MOFA. Now, this will render the recent state DGP circular asking police to file FIRs against developers null and void. But in its place, home buyers can expect another set of deadlines, guidelines for the police. Now, Ruchi Deshpande gets us this exclusive.
We told you here on Magic Bricks Now that the Maharashtra government officials are considering combining the remainder rules of Maharashtra Ownership Flats Act or MOFA into the current rules being framed for the new Maharashtra Housing Regulator. Now, sources from the Maharashtra Home Department tell us that the recommendations to include the remainder of MOFA in the new RERA rules have already reached the Housing Ministry, where they are being considered right now. What's more is that this move, according to the Home Department officials, says that this will empower the consumers against errant builders, give them more teeth so that they are not duped by these builders. But if MOFA and RERA are combined right now, then the current circular which was issued by the Maharashtra Director General of Police that stated that you could go register an FIR and get the builder arrested after certain conditions will be inactive. This means that if MOFA and RERA are combined, this circular will be inactive. It will cease to exist. Currently, remember that these recommendations have only gone from the Maharashtra Home Department to the Maharashtra Housing Department, where they are being considered by the Maharashtra Housing Department. And it will be some time before the MOFA is repealed, which will take at least 2 months, according to what sources told us. And it will take time for the circular to be either repealed or for it to be inactive. And we will keep you updated about it on Magic Bricks Now.
Now, we also caught up with Uday Vavikar earlier today, and he tells us how the coexistence of RERA will impact home buyers.
Well, our recommendation was that both should coexist, MOFA and RERA, because they are complementary to each other. And it could have been a long-winded life. But if they want to now put MOFA, it is also a welcome move that they want to put the MOFA provisions under RERA. But the question would be, under MOFA, there's a criminal liability where a builder can be sued criminally. Therefore, the police said that you can file a FIR. But now, with this, we do not really know, and we keep our fingers crossed that all those effective sections of MOFA, including the parking and the deemed conveyance, are taken as it is. And there is not much change in that, or they are not liquidated or diluted. That is, I am very, very optimistic. But we'll have to be really cautious. Till such time it is merged, till such time it comes in gazette, that circular should have been continued. Because in any case, if you say that circular is not effective and if MOFA is not repealed till such time, then you can go under MOFA, file a criminal complaint in the criminal court for investigation. If the MOFA is not repealed, they can file a criminal complaint in the criminal court, and then the magistrate can tell them to investigate, direct the police to investigate in the matter and lodge a FIR. That option is still open as long as MOFA is not repealed. If it is not repealed till such time the new act is formed, new act is gazetted, it is good. But if it is immediately repealed, then we'll have no option. Then you have to go to consumer court, get an order and send builder to the jail.
Meanwhile, in the national capital, the war for Delhi continues. In another press conference on Wednesday, the AAP has attacked the lieutenant governor and called him a puppet of the Modi government. Now, the AAP government has also raised 5 questions with the LG and sought answers. Deepa Rana gets us this report.
The standoff between the AAP-led Delhi government as well as the lieutenant governor has taken a new turn in the national capital. Today, in a press conference, AAP spokesperson Dilip Pandey attacked the lieutenant governor and raised questions as that he is acting on the advice of the Prime Minister. In fact, the Aam Aadmi Party government has also called the lieutenant governor a puppet of the Modi government. In fact, the AAP spokesperson has asked direct 5 questions from the lieutenant governor pertaining to why the premium bus service, which was introduced by the Aam Aadmi Party government in the national capital, was rejected by the lieutenant governor. Also, a bus lane proposal is still pending with the lieutenant governor and has not got a nod yet. Also, the AAP-led AAP spokesperson Dilip Pandey raised questions as to why, being the head of the Delhi Development Authority, the lieutenant governor has not asked it to clear a property tax of 1200 crores to the MCDs, despite the fact that MCD workers have not got their dues in time and that their salaries have not been cleared yet. Now, in this ongoing turf war between the Delhi government as well as the lieutenant governor, it is now that the citizens have been suffering day after day, despite the fact that the civic amenities and other issues are not being attended to or not being addressed to by the Delhi government.
Now, citizens are at the receiving end, not just in Delhi, but also in Bhiwandi after a series of building collapses in Bhiwandi. Now, the corporation has speeded up eviction of residents from dangerous buildings. In fact, after evicting over 500 people from 3 buildings on Tuesday, the civic body on Wednesday went ahead to demolish the 4th building, which resided over 40 families. My colleague Desha Shah, who was in Bhiwandi earlier today, gets us this ground report.
I'm standing here right now at Hanuman Tekadi in Bhiwandi near Mumbai, where right now you can see just behind me a 35-year-old building is being currently demolished by the Bhiwandi Nizampur Municipal Corporation. In fact, the corporation says that this building has been tagged as in the most dangerous category, and the workers have started demolishing this building from Wednesday morning. In fact, right now also you can see that the workers are ensuring here that the building is demolished in a day's time. In fact, when we spoke to the local residents out here, we came to know that there were close to 40 to 45 families residing in this particular building, and few families moved out after getting eviction notices. But right now you can see that few families preferred here to stay because they say that, you know, the corporation has not given them any alternate accommodation as promised. Right now you can see that all their, you know, home utensils, the kitchen utensils, all the furniture is, they have kept it bang opposite the compound. In fact, you can see right now here there are several residents waiting for the corporation's, you know, for the corporation's notice to take them to any sort of night shelters or, you know, any other alternate accommodation as promised by the corporation. In fact, when we spoke to the residents, they tell us that none of the civic authorities have come here to rescue them. Only the workers are here demolishing, but they have not been given any alternate accommodation. Other 45 families moved to their relatives' place, but these families, they say that they have nowhere else to go, and they are just waiting for the corporation's alternate accommodation. This is Disha Shah reporting for Magic Bricks now.
Now, Disha also caught up with the local corporator Azhar Sheikh from the Congress Party. Now, he says that the corporation is trying its best to accommodate each and every home buyer.
कॉर्पोरेशन ने रात्रि निवास के अंदर इंतजाम किया हुआ, यहाँ के अंदर जो शादी हॉल है, फराउन हॉल वगैरह, ऐसे 6-8 शादी हॉल है, उसके अंदर इंतजाम करा हुआ है। और यहाँ से थोड़ा लंबा और होने की वजह से यहाँ से लोग जाते नहीं। और ये बिल्डिंग जो है अभी फिलहाल, इसकी बात करें तो यहाँ पे रात में कल 12 बजे ऐसा कुछ लगा कि दीवार गिर रही है, तो सारे लोगों ने खाली करके सामने वाले कंपाउंड के अंदर रुके और कुछ लोग चले गए।
On the other hand, the corporation also maintaining records when it comes to the residents?
No, इस corporation के corporation इनको पंचनामा बना के देगी, जो जिनके खुद के घर है उनको पूरा पूरा पंचनामा, जितना स्क्वायर फीट उनका घर है उतना पंचनामा जिसके नाम पे है, उनकी घर पट्टी वगैरह, वो रिकॉर्ड बनाने का काम भी यहीं चालू है। और जो रेंट वाले है वो तो अपना डिपॉजिट लेके चले जाएंगे, और जिनका खुद का है उनका पंचनामा बना के उनको मिल जाएगा। तब बिल्डिंग बनेंगी तो उनके पास रिकॉर्ड रहेगा अपना।
Now, residents who are now homeless, on the other hand, say that the corporation has done absolutely nothing to provide them alternate accommodation.
अभी हमारी corporation से यही डिमांड है, हम यही उनको बोलना चाहते हैं कि देखो सारी फैमिलियां, सारी औरतें इस 45 फैमिली इसमें रहती है, ये सब आज रोड पर सामान लेकर बैठे हैं रात भर से, इनको रहने के लिए तुरंत ताबड़तोड़ इनको जगह देनी चाहिए, ये जिम्मेदारी कॉर्पोरेशन की बनती है।
हम लोग के ऊपर ध्यान देना चाहिए, हम लोग इतनी परेशान है, हमारा कुछ सहारा करना चाहिए, हम कहाँ जाए।
हम ये सहारे के लिए बाल बच्चों के लिए अपने छतरी है, वो भी बेघर हो गया, अब जाए तो कहाँ जाए, गोली लेने के लिए पैसे नहीं हमारे पास में।
बच्चे लोग को स्कूल की तकलीफ हो रही है, रहने की प्रॉब्लम, और हम एक पैर के अपाहिज है, एक बहन मेरी आँख से नहीं देखती, हम लोग इतनी परेशानी है, वो बहन को हम दूसरे जगह भेजे, कहाँ लेके बैठेंगे।
हम लोग रात से यहाँ पे पड़े हैं, ना कोई हम लोग का सहारा है, ना कुछ है, हम लोग किधर जाएंगे हा? और यहाँ वाले कोई सुनवाई नहीं हो रही है, कोई सुन नहीं रहा है, और तोड़ रहा है बिल्डिंग हम लोग की।
छोटे छोटे बच्चे हैं, जरा ये तो करना चाहिए, कोई मदद करे, ये बिल्डिंग टूटी है उनको कोई भेजे, कोई कुछ खिलाए। अरे मासूम बच्चों का तो ख्याल रखो तुम लोग, बड़ों को तो छोड़ दो, ये बात ऐसी करना चाहिए ना, कोई समझदारी की बात करने वाला नहीं है।
बगैर डिसीजन के तोड़ दिए है, कोई डिसीजन देखे नहीं है, कहाँ से क्या है क्या नहीं है, अभी छोटे छोटे बच्चे बारिश में लेकर परेशान हो जाएंगे हम लोग।
FIBCOM में हमने इतना तकलीफ है, पावर भी नहीं, कैसे पढ़ूंगा क्या करूंगा मैं, पानी भी काट दिए, पावर भी काट दिए, कुछ नहीं।
अभी हम लोग का जो है गवर्नमेंट से इल्तिजा है कि वो मतलब हमारे को जो रूम है जिनका जिनका उनको मतलब गवर्नमेंट डिपार्टमेंट दे।
देखिए ऐसा है कि आप भिवंडी के हो या ठाणा के हो या मुंब्रा के हो, कहाँ से भी हो, आप महाराष्ट्र के नागरिक है, महाराष्ट्र के सिटीजन है, इसके लिए महाराष्ट्र सरकार की जिम्मेदारी बनती है कि आपको जितनी जल्दी हो सके मदद करना। अर्बन डेवलपमेंट डिपार्टमेंट चीफ मिनिस्टर के साथ है और अल्टीमेटली चीफ मिनिस्टर महाराष्ट्र के मुखिया है, उनकी जवाबदारी बनती है और हम वो जवाबदारी से भागने की कोशिश नहीं कर रहे, एक मुद्दा नंबर एक है। अभी थोड़ा सा सहकार्य आपसे भी होना चाहिए, यदि 200-250 बिल्डिंग्स भिवंडी में यदि खाली करनी पड़ी समझो, तो ये 200-250 लोगों को तुरंत भिवंडी के उनके बिल्डिंग के आसपास ही शेल्टर मिलने की बिल्कुल संभावना ही है, ऐसा हो भी नहीं सकता। थोड़ी सी कठिनाई आपने उठानी चाहिए, थोड़ी सी हेल्प गवर्नमेंट ने करनी चाहिए, क्योंकि ये छोटा सा प्रॉब्लम, ये छोटा सा प्रॉब्लम नहीं है,
मॉनिटरी
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल होना चाहिए। मैं सहमत हूँ,
कहीं पर जाके भाड़े पे रहना चाहे,
नहीं मैं सहमत हूँ
सरकार की तरफ से,
मैं बिल्कुल सहमत हूँ, बिल्कुल
किराए पे जाकर के रह सकते हैं, जहाँ पर कम से कम किराया इनको भरना पड़े।
अगर आप यहाँ के नागरिक से एक्सपेक्ट कर रहे हैं कि वो अपने जेब से खर्च करके कुछ काम करना चाहिए, रहने सहने का बंदोबस्त करना चाहिए, खाने पीने की चीज़ों का बंदोबस्त करना चाहिए, वो लोग तो पूरी तरह से डिमोलिश हो गए बिल्डिंग के साथ ही।
नहीं मैंने ऐसा नहीं कहा, मैंने ऐसा नहीं कहा, मैंने ऐसा नहीं कहा ममता जी,
कॉर्पोरेशन से उनको मिलना चाहिए था वो भी नहीं मिला है। कहा है कि आपने ये कहा है कि उनको भी गवर्नमेंट के साथ में कॉपरेशन करना चाहिए। अब शेल्टर नहीं है, आप बताइए अगर 200-250 लोग अगर बिल्डिंगे हैं उनके लिए कोई भी ट्रांजिट कैंप अगर नहीं है यहाँ पर, तो कॉरपोरेशन के जिम्मेदारों की यह जिम्मेदारी नहीं होती है? जो लोग यहाँ के नागरिकों से चुनाव चुनकर आते हैं, क्या उनकी जिम्मेदारी नहीं बनती है?
नहीं नहीं आपने मुझे लगता है
हम लोग अपने तौर पर यहाँ जो भी इनको कॉपरेशन मिला है लोकल लेवल पे मिला है साहब।
भैया आपने ठीक तरीके से
यहाँ
सुना
पर
नहीं है।
इनको अब तक का जो कॉपरेशन मिला है लोकल लेवल पर मिला है, जो सोशल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है उन्होंने काम किया है यहाँ पर,
जो गवर्नमेंट की पॉलिसी प्रोजेक्ट अफेक्टेड पीपल के लिए है।
एग्जैक्टली
वो प्रोजेक्ट अफेक्टेड पीपल की पॉलिसी इन पे इम्प्लीमेंट होनी चाहिए और इनको उस पॉलिसी का फायदा मिलना चाहिए। दिस इज व्हाट आई वुड लाइक टू सजेस्ट टू द करंट गवर्नमेंट, क्योंकि दे हैव अ पीएपी पॉलिसी, प्रोजेक्ट अफेक्टेड पीपल। दे कैन बी ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड इनटू प्रोजेक्ट अफेक्टेड पीपल
और दे कैन बी ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड इनटू पॉलिसी ऑफ स्पेशल पर्पस व्हीकल्स है कि हमें तमाम तरह की सुविधा मिलनी चाहिए मगर यहां तो कंडीशन ये है कि खाक हो जाएंगे हम तुमको खबर होने तक।
हां हां वही सुविधा आपको उसमें मेडिकल की सुविधा मिल सकती है आपको उसमें
सर,
रेंट
जो
में आर्थिक
की आप
मदद
बात
मिल सकती
आप
है
ना,
आपको उसको खाने के लिए
आप
कुछ आपको आर्थिक मदद दे सकते हैं इस तरह
सर,
की सुविधा सब दे सकते हैं।
आपकी जिम्मेदार गवर्नमेंट जो है कब तक इनकी मदद करेगी?
आपकी नहीं हमारी भैया आपकी नहीं हमारी हमारी यासीन जी आपकी नहीं हमारी आपको पूछना चाहता हूँ आपका गवर्नमेंट कौन सा है? आप बोलते हैं आपकी गवर्नमेंट तो आपकी गवर्नमेंट कौन सी है? यह हमारी गवर्नमेंट है, यह आपकी और हमारी मिलकर गवर्नमेंट बनी है। हमारी गवर्नमेंट अलग और आपकी गवर्नमेंट अलग नहीं हो सकती। यू आर अ पार्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, यू कैनॉट डिस्टिंग्विश योरसेल्फ अवे फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट। आई जस्ट वांट टू क्लेरिफाई व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय
उनकी हमारी गवर्नमेंट। तो मैं माइनॉरिटी जाने की जरूरत नहीं है,
आई टेक अ पॉइंट। वो बेचारे रोड ही होने में डिबेट नहीं कर रहे हैं।
मुझे बस यही सुनना है, मुझे बस यही सुनना है कि आज रात भिवंडी के लोग जिस जिनके बिल्डिंगे गिरे, जिनको इवैक्यूएट किया गया, वो आज रात को कहां रह रहे हैं?
9 बजे गिरी है सर, मैं बताना चाहूंगा। हेलो,
यस बोलिए।
बिल्डिंग 9 बजे गिरी है और वहां पे स्पॉट पे हम लोग पहुंच के कॉर्पोरेशन में फोन करते हैं कि जल्दी जल्दी आपातकालीन दल भेजिए। अगर वहां पे बराबर टाइम पे अगर सुविधा पहुंची होती, टाइम पे लोग पहुंचे होते, आपातकालीन के लोग टाइम पे पहुंचे होते, तो हो सकता है कुछ लोगों की जान बचाई जा सकती थी, लेकिन ऐसा नहीं हुआ। वहां पे 11 से 12 बजे 2-3 घंटा लेट नगर पालिका से फायर ब्रिगेड आता है, वहां से आपातकालीन दल के लोग आते हैं, तो उसमें जो बेचारे बचने वाले वो भी नहीं बचे।
अब्दुल वाक जी, आई जस्ट हैव वन रिक्वेस्ट। आप अगर चीफ मिनिस्टर जी से बात कर सकते हैं, देवेंद्र फडणवीस जी से बात कर सकते हैं और उनको बता सकते हैं कि आपने आज शो पे क्या सुना और आपको इन लोगों ने क्या उम्मीद है अभी स्टेट गवर्नमेंट से। माय रिकमेंडेशन टू यू इज that these people need to be rehabilitated. Tonight they have no place to stay. Their children have no place to sleep. The larger problems of how we are going to solve this will require a deeper state policy. I accept. It's very complicated. I accept that as well. But just so they have a safe, warm, dry place to sleep in the night, can we appeal to the Chief Minister to solve that problem? Ki aap Chief Minister se baat karke in logon ko अनुशासन दे सकते हैं कि आप बात करेंगे चीफ मिनिस्टर जी से?
नहीं, मैं हिंदी में बताना चाहता हूँ।
The member parliament in Bhiwandi is of BJP only.
Go ahead, अब्दुल वाक।
नहीं, वैसे तो महाराष्ट्र में out of 48, 42 तो शिवसेना बीजेपी के है अभी। तो मैं ये बताना चाहता हूँ कि इस कार्यक्रम के बाद
कि इनकी जिम्मेवारी और ज्यादा बन रही है।
हाँ जी, हाँ जी, सब राजी।
क्योंकि वहाँ पर MLA और MP जो हैं वो बीजेपी शिवसेना के हैं, तो उसको तुरंत रिएक्ट करना चाहिए।
हाँ जी, मैं यही कहना चाहता हूँ आपको कि
बताइए क्या करने वाले हैं आप अभी।
जिस प्रकार एक प्रोग्राम होने के बाद मैं तुरंत थाने के कलेक्टर से बात करूंगा, भिवंडी निजामपुर म्युनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन के कमिश्नर से बात करूंगा और चीफ मिनिस्टर को भी अवगत करूंगा इस सिचुएशन के बारे में, एंड इनको ये बताऊंगा कि ये क्या हो रहा है और उसके बाद में जो निर्णय लेना है सरकार ले।
Well, four buildings down in Bhiwandi and citizens at the receiving end tell us that the corporation has done absolutely nothing. Meanwhile, news just coming in, A.A. Shringare has been appointed as the Municipal Commissioner of Bhiwandi Nizampur Municipal Corporation from the 11th of August. He is currently serving as the Chairman of Divisional Caste Scrutiny in Navi Mumbai. Shringare will take charge on Thursday. Magic Bricks Now, meanwhile, will revisit the story and continue to bring you regular updates. From Mumbai to the demolition drive in Bengaluru, where the state government continues to demolish properties which have encroached on stormwater drains and canals from natural lakes. While the state government has accepted that it was a nexus of builders and corrupt government officials that led to the disappearance of the city's lakes to begin with, the first to suffer are the common people who are losing their homes. CM Siddaramaiah has given the people a commitment that the government will take legal action against corrupt officials. Anusha Ravi gets us the latest.
Nexus of builders, developers and corrupt government officials led to the disappearance of stormwater drains across the city of Bengaluru. Apartments, plots, layouts sprung up in their place. However, today, the common citizen a tax-paying citizen of the city of Bengaluru is paying the price for this very nexus. As now, the government has decided to demolish all plots, property and layouts that were allegedly constructed encroaching upon stormwater drains. This move from the government is being appreciated by many, but a thought is not being spared for those dozens of Bengalurians, tax-paying citizens, who have lost their house, their dreams, their future.
Meanwhile, Chief Minister Siddaramaiah said that law will take its course and the guilty will be punished, but will continue with the demolition.
Because you have the Bangalore development portfolio, these demolitions are being done on a war footing.
It is a decision of the government. I am not attacking anybody. Those who violated law and constructed unauthorizedly in the Rajakalwe and in the lakes, those people will be removing them.
They trusted the BBMP and built their house.
What?
They trusted the BBMP and built their house. So how do you hold them?
Whether they are officers or builders or anybody, those who violated the law takes its own course. We are going to take legal actions against them.
Now, we also caught up with the resident of Bengaluru. Listen in to what he had to say.
Yes, ultimately the home buyers are losers, but the K.V. Tempter, that maxim, Latin maxim on which the law is based, the people should always remember that factor.
So, do you think in this scenario, when you look at it as an outsider,
yes,
in the nexus between builders, developers and officials, yes, that a common man is being made the scapegoat?
Yes, yes, common man is made the scapegoat because they are not fully aware of the law while purchasing the property. That is why these BBMP people, they will try to extract the benefit from the people.
Moving on, the Cabinet has approved Motor Vehicle Amendment Bill 2016 on the 9th of August. With a major focus on road safety, 68 out of 223 sections from the current Motor Vehicles Act have been amended. Now, will the new amendments impact your commute? The proposal is now with the Standing Committee, is what Magic Bricks Now learns. However, if it gets cleared, along with increasing fines for drunken driving, over-speeding, not wearing helmets, etc., the government will also make it mandatory for children over 4 years to compulsorily wear helmets. The government at the moment, along with other amendments, is strongly considering increasing safety for children, along with making norms more stricter. But what do citizens of Mumbai think about this move? We caught up with a couple of citizens and asked them what they think. Listen in.
Everyone should be deterred, you know, from doing any kind of wrongdoing or traffic. Pedestrians' life matter a lot, yeah. Even life of other vehicle drivers matter a lot.
I feel whatever is happening, that's good. Whatever law they are creating, it's good. It's for the people, whatever they are doing. Whatever the revenues which they are going to generate, it's good for the people. And people will have that fear that I have to pay 10 times, so maybe I'll kick and carry helmet or let's not drink and drive because charges are getting very high. Instead of 100 rupees for a helmet, now you have to pay 1,000. So 10 times you think about it, let's carry a helmet and then go for the driving. So it's good, and I believe it's sometimes fear is good. So you go ahead with the things.
Fine zyada hoega, ek limit tak theek hai. Agar zyada agar karega to fir apna uska actually ek benefit hi hoega ki log ye jo kar rahe hai, jo helmet without helmet ghum rahe hai aur seat belt nahi laga rahe, wo ek tarah se ek achhi baat hai aur uske ऐसा, बट इतना भी फाइन नहीं होना चाहिए कि कॉमन मैन को थोड़ा ये हो जाए, फिर उसमें करप्शन भी बढ़ जाएगा उसके अंदर भी, अगर क्योंकि जो ज़्यादा फाइन रहेगा कोई अफोर्ड नहीं कर पाएगा, उसके वजह से वापस फिर करप्शन बढ़ेगा.
Moving on, the Minister of State for Urban Development and Housing and Urban Poverty Alleviation, Rao Inderjeet Singh, in a written reply in Lok Sabha today, stated that 25 cities from 8 states prepared a comprehensive mobility plan with central assistance. Now, the minister also stated that the Ministry of Urban Development will assist up to 80% of cost of preparation of CMPs, which will be subsequently be a part of city's master plans. These CMPs will be prepared based on origin and destination flow of traffic, identifying major traffic corridors and feeder corridors, land use, etc. 14 cities are from the state of Karnataka, 5 from Punjab, and few cities from the rest of the states have prepared their comprehensive plan till date. Also in the news, the Lieutenant Governor held a meeting with the Delhi Development Authority or DDA officials today. The authority has asked for permission to build integrated townships at Dwarka, Rohini and Narela. The townships will be built with city-level public-private partnerships. Now, the DDA has also submitted a proposal to the Lieutenant Governor requesting for a 100% interest waiver on dues of the Kashmiri migrant allottees. Now, among other proposals approved today was a scrapping of allotment of alternative plots to evictees in New Konli Resettlement Colony. This will lead to auctioning of vacant plots to general public. Finally, a change of land use proposal was also cleared for construction of offices, registrar general and census commissioner in residential areas in central Delhi's Man Singh Road, which also boasts of Delhi's Taj Man Singh Hotel. Some good news coming in for HDFC Limited customers. You can now purchase your CIBIL score and report directly from the HDFC Limited website within seconds. The Credit Information Bureau Limited or CIBIL announced this offering exclusively for HDFC Limited customers today via their CIBIL Consumer Connect solution. Now, the CIBIL score is a key factor that banks assess to decide on whether or not to lend to an individual. Now, through this website, borrowers can now monitor their CIBIL score regularly. With that, we've completely run out of time here on the Property News on Magic Bricks Now. Thank you for watching.
Should the local municipalities be going out and demolishing homes in this manner?
We are looking at an act of God. Generally, at
this
time,
is an act of the BBMP, Brijesh Kalapa. This is not an act of God. There were bulldozers that came in and knocked down someone's home.
During the wartime, you go on a practice. This is what is the government doing. What were they doing? They were waiting till monsoon to come.
You call up all those people that gave the permissions to these people and say, you know what, let's prosecute them first.
I can say that it is an inhuman act. For that, I will hold the three important agencies of government responsible. One is BBMP, number two is BDA. Number three, the BWSSB.
Why are they not following the CDT and why are they insisting on the village map?
If we are referring to a map that is 100 years old, isn't this then a case for land acquisition and not illegal demolition?
I have asked this question to the chief engineers over there. I tried to ask the same to the commissioner and he just walked out. He didn't say anything.
We are paying the heavy price. I think we should stop listening to this all the senseless argument. We want solution and I would demand the solution.
Are you watching The Urban Debate? Only on Magic Bricks Now. You can watch live TV on our website mbnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at Magic Bricks Now. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.